kind of in that middle thing. We have fulvestrant, we have aromatase inhibitors, but now let's really turn to CDK4 because I think that's an important thing coming down the pike. And, you know, again, I'll turn to Dr. Finn, who I think is, you know, an expert in this. And, you know, what are your feelings about the use of CDK4 inhibitors as first-line therapy?
Obviously, the data from the Paloma-1 TRIO-18 study was very provocative. This was the randomized phase 2 study that evaluated letrozole plus palbociclib versus letrozole alone for first-line ER-positive postmenopausal breast cancer. And we saw a significant improvement in PFS with that regimen from 10.2 months to over 20 months. That's very dramatic. It was an open-label study, relatively small, 150 patients in that set, or over 150, just over. The drug was very well tolerated, a predictable profile of neutropenia, but no complications from that neutropenia's fever. The phase 3 studies have been accrued, the Paloma-2 and Paloma-3, Paloma-2 being the same population in frontline as Paloma-1. And, you know, at this time, we need to wait for those phase 3 results. Obviously, there's movement to maybe get the drug approved earlier, and we'll have to wait for that, but there's a lot of excitement. I share that excitement, and potentially this could be a practice-changing observation.
So I guess the first question is, you know, any particular side effects people have to worry about with these drugs that are over and above what we normally do with hormonal therapy?
The thing that have come out is really the neutropenia. This is an expected on-target type of effect, but the observation is different from a cytotoxic type of neutropenia. The drug is typically dosed on 3 weeks on, 1 week off. Per protocol, patients had to have an ANC of 1,000 to resume their next cycle. But what we saw in the study, while many patients required some dose delay or dose adjustment, the dose intensity was still very high. Patients were able to stay on the drug and stay on the drug for a long period of time without having neutropenic fever, without the requirement for growth factors. So we are usually not checking labs so frequently on patients on endocrine therapy alone. But I think if the magnitude of benefit is held up in future studies, this won't be an issue for physicians or patients.
So Kim, assuming that palbociclib gets accelerated approval based on the phase 2, would you use it?
Sure.
You would?
Well, I think we use many agents that improve progression-free survival without an overall survival advantage. I would point out that there are two other CDK inhibitors that are currently in similar clinical trials as the Paloma study. And so I would encourage people to think about those studies independent of whether or not the Pfizer CDK inhibitor gets approved, because I think it offers the patients an opportunity to participate in clinical trials, but also have access to drugs that aren't available right now.
And would you use it too, Lee?
Yes, I've been involved in the Paloma too, and of course it's double blind, so I don't know what patients are getting, but I can say that the patients we've had on trial, their toxicities have been manageable. And so, yes, I think if it's approved based on the phase 2, until we have the phase 3, it will be very useful.